हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई वांट टू डिस्कस एक्सरसाइज 3.4 ऑफ चैप्टर 3 स्क्वेयर्स एंड स्क्वेयर रूट्स। क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 स्टेटमेंट इज फाइंड द स्मॉलेस्ट स्क्वेयर नंबर व्हिच इज डिविजिबल बाय ईच ऑफ द नंबर्स 6, 9 एंड 15। आंसर इज द लीस्ट नंबर डिविजिबल बाय Each of the numbers 6, 9 and 15 is their LCM. So LCM of 6, 9 and 15. You can take LCM of 6, 9 and 15. Here is the LCM of 6, 9 and 15. 3 into 3 into 2 into 5. 3, 3 the 9, 9 to the 18, 18, 5 the 90. 90 is the LCM of 6, 9 and 15. Now, by prime factorization of 90, we can write 90 as 3 into 3 into 2 into 5. Now, you can see that here one pair of 3. Here is not a pair of 2 and 5. 2 is a single digit number and 5 is also a single digit number. The prime factors 2 and 5 are not in pairs. You can see that here prime factors 2 and 5 not in pairs. For the number to be a perfect square, each factor of the number must have a pair. For any number to be a perfect square, each number in a pair. To make pairs of 2 and 5, to make pairs of 2 and 5, the number 90 has to be multiplied by 2 into 5, 10. Because here 2 and 5 are not in pairs, so multiply 90 by 2, one more 2, because if we have 2, then we have 2 in a pair. If we have 5, then we have 5 in a pair. 2 into 5, 10. Hence the required square number is 90 multiply 10 is 900. You can see that 900 is a perfect square number. 900 is a square of 30 because 30 square is 900. And 900 is divisible by 6. 900 is divisible by 9. 900 is divisible by 15. So 900 is a smallest perfect square number which is divisible by 6, 9 and 15. Second question, find the smallest number by which 5392 must be divided so that the quotient is a perfect square. Find the square root of the quotient. Answer is prime factorization of 5392. 5392 divided by 2, we get 2696. 2696 divided by 2, we get 1348 divided by 2, we get 674 divided by 2, we get 337 divided by 337, we get 1. So we can write 5392 as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 337. Now you can see that this is in pair. This is also in a pair, and 337 is not in a pair. So 337 is the smallest number. Now 5392 divide 337, we get 16. Now prime factorization of 16 as square root of 16 as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, because 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16. Now from a pair of 2 into 2, we have 2. From a pair of 2 into 2, we have 2. 2 to the 4. Square root of 16 is 4. 16 is a perfect square number. Question number 5. The product of two numbers is 2197. If one of the numbers is 13 times the other number, find the numbers. Answer is the product of two numbers we have given 2197. Let one number equal to x, let other number 13 multiply x, 13x, because we have given the other numbers is 13 times the first number. Let first number x, let other number is 13 multiply x, 13x. According to question, 13x multiply x equal to 2197. 13x into x, 13x square equal to 2197. X square equal to 2197 divided by 13. X square equal to 169. X equal to, when you remove square, then x equal to square root of 169. Now, square root of 169 is 13 into 13. From a pair of 13 into 13, we get 13. So, x equal to 13. One number we have x, x equal to 13. In the other number 13x, 13 multiply x. 13 multiply 13 equal to 169. So, first number x and second number is 169. Question number 7. A rectangular field is 81 meter long and 49 meter wide. A square has the same area as that of a rectangular field. Find the side of the square. In this question, we have given a rectangular field whose length is 81 meter and breadth is 49 meter. A square has a same area that of a rectangular field. We have given the area of square equal to area of rectangular field. We have to find the side of a square. Length of a rectangular field equal to 81 meter. We have given. Breadth of a rectangular field 49 meter. Now area of rectangular field, we know that the area of rectangular field is length multiply breadth. 81 multiply 49. 81 multiply 49, we get 3969. Let side of square equal to x. Then area of square is side multiply side, x multiply x, x square. Now we are given both area are equal. So x square, that is area of square, equal to 3969, that is area of rectangular. According to question, both are equal. So x equal to square root of 3969. So x equal to 63. 63 square is 3969. Here you can see that 3 square root of 3969 divided by 3, we get 1323 divided by 3, we get 441. 441 divided by 3, we get 147. 147 divided by 3, we get 49. 49 divided by 7, we get 7. 7 divided by 7, we get 1. So square root of 3969 as 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 7 into 7. From a pair of 3 into 3 we get 3. From a pair of 3 into 3 we get 3. From a pair of 7 into 7 we get 7. 3 3 the 9, 9 7 the 63. So square root of 3969 is 63. Question number 8. School collected rupees 11,025 as fee from its students. If each student paid as much money as there were students in a school, how many students were there in a school? Answer is, let total number of students equal to x. According to question, x multiply x equal to 11,025. Because each student pays as money as the number of students. Here the number of students equal to x. Let each student pay rupees x. So number of students we have let x. Therefore we have total money x multiply x. That is x square. So x square equal to 11,025. X equal to square root of 11,025. Now prime factorization of 11,025. You can see that 11,025 divided by 3, we get 3,675. 3,675 divided by 3, we get 1,225. 1,225 divided by 5, we get 245. 245 divided by 5, we get 49. 49 divided by 7 we get 7, 7 divided by 7 we get 1. Now 11,025 we can write as 3 into 3 into 5 into 5 into 7 into 7. From a pair of 3 into 3 we get 3, from a pair of 5 into 5 we get 7, from a pair of 7 into 7 we get 7, 3 into 5 15, 15 into 7 105. So x equal to 105. So total number of students is 105. 105 is your required answer. Question number 9. Find the smallest number by which 27,783 must be multiplied so that it becomes a perfect square number. So 27,783 is not a perfect square number. We have to find the smallest number by which it should be multiplied so as to get a perfect square number. Now prime factorization of 27,783 divided by 3 we get 9,261 divided by 3 we get 3,087 divided by 3 we get 1,029 divided by 3 we get 343 divided by 7 we get 49 divided by 7 we get 7 divided by 7 we get 1. Now square root of 27,783 is 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 7 into 7. Now you can see that here 3 into 3 which is in a pair, 3 into 3 which is also in a pair, 7 into 7 which is also in a pair, and 7 is not in the pair. So 7 is the smallest number. Question number 10. The product of two numbers is 2205 and their quotient is 9 over 5. Find the numbers. Here given the product of two numbers is 2205 and their quotient is 9 over 5. We have to find the numbers. Let the one number equal to x. Let the other number is 2205 upon x. Because you can see that when you multiply these two numbers, you get 2205. According to question, we are given that x over 2205 upon x. When you divide x over 2205 over x, you get quotient. And we are also given that quotient is 9 by 5. So according to question, 9 by 5 is quotient and this is also a quotient, so both are equal. So x multiply reciprocal of 2205 by x is x multiply x over 2205 equal to 9 over 5. X into x, x square over 2205 equal to 9 by 5. Then do cross multiplication. 5 into x square, 9 into 2205, x square equal to 9 into 2205 upon 5, because 5 is in multiplication, here 5 is in divide. 5 on the 5, 2205 divided by 5 we get 441. 441 multiply 9 we get 3969, and x square equal to 3969, x equal to square root of 3969 is 63. So x equal to 63. One number 63 and the other number 2205 over x, put x equal to 63. 2205 over 63, 2205 divided by 63 we get 35. So we have one number 63 and other number is 35. This is your required answer. Thank you.